The Scubapro factory in Casarza Ligure, Italy, established in 1974, is the place where all Scubapro regulators, most buoyancy compensators, and some other items are built. It all starts with the CAD drawings of the approved production design, which are prepared in the R&D department, also located in Casarza. The computer models are turned into real parts by machinery, which bends or shapes brass or molds plastic components. To produce a metal second stage, the preassembled pieces are heated and welded together. This operation needs to be performed by experienced and highly skilled workers to ensure that high production standards are maintained. Plastic second stages are instead created by injection molding. Each hand-welded piece is then pressure tested at 4 bars. The testing is done in the water to check if there are any leaks. The pieces that pass the test are then sent forward to the polishing and chrome plating stage. The first stage is manufactured from a solid brass rod that gets cut to size and machined. An industrial robot takes the pieces from one production step to the other. At each workstation, computer numerical controlled or CNC machines perform their job with the utmost precision. Part of this work is done off-site by selected, specialized suppliers that meet Scubapro's strict requirements and use top-of-the-line industrial equipment. This ensures a quick turnaround of components and the highest quality. This machine stamps the low-pressure and high-pressure markings on the regulator ports before the pieces are sent to chrome plating. Skilled operators then assemble the finished first stage components manually. Before assembling the pieces together, each one undergoes a visual check to verify that parts are free from defects. The HP orifice is inserted in the body. Next, the diaphragm, the spring, and the poppet are installed. All the components work together to reduce the pressure of the air from the tank to the intermediate pressure that is fed into the regulator second stage. To complete the assembly, the regulator body is tightened with a torque wrench to prevent over-tightening, as this could damage the regulator body. The same tool is then used to install the yoke fitting, or the DIN fitting, in the DIN version of the regulator, which will allow the first stage to be connected to the tank valve. The regulator second stage assembly procedure is similar. The exhaust valve diaphragm is installed. Then the exhaust cover is fitted and locked in place. The valve, the most important part of the second stage, is assembled and installed next. Along the process, the technician performs various checks. Finally, the front cover is screwed on and locked with the safety pin. Several steps of this assembly process require the use of specialized tools. First and second stages are now calibrated. The first stage is mounted on a movable valve that will pressurize it to 300 bar or 4300 psi. The first stage is adjusted until the desired intermediate pressure is achieved and then submerged in water for an accurate visual check to ensure there are no leaks. If the first stage performs as expected, it goes on to the next step. The second stage is crucial to the quality of the diving experience. It has to work just right. Each second stage is connected to the first stage, completing the regulator system, and is then tested under pressure. The technician checks the inhalation effort and adjusts the second stage as required, using a special tool. Finally, he installs the adjustment knob and checks the pressures once again. Then, the regulator system goes on to the transport rack, where it will rest for 24 hours before undergoing another check. Regulators that pass this final check receive the matching serial number markings, which identifies each regulator system. At this point, the finished regulator system is packaged along with the user manual CD-ROM and the printed quick start guide, and it's stored in the factory warehouse. The next inspector is our customer. This plaque on the wall of the quality control laboratory clearly explains Scubapro's core values. Products must be perfect before being allowed out of the factory. To reach this lofty goal, each component undergoes rigorous testing, which ranges from visual checks to mechanical controls, up to destructive testing done on random samples. A buoyancy compensator, randomly selected from the production line, is inflated to its maximum capacity and deflated again several thousand times to verify that it will operate perfectly for extended periods of time. All buoyancy compensators are also verified after production. Valves are hand-tightened, then zippers, straps, and all other details are checked one by one. Buoyancy compensators are then inflated to their maximum capacity, and the pressure is checked after a predefined amount of time to verify that there are no leaks. Then they move on to the packaging department. Before being packaged, each buoyancy compensator is visually inspected once again, and items such as the low-pressure hose, the user manual, and the hand tags are added. The buoyancy compensator is now ready for shipping. The factory warehouse receives and stocks all parts needed to manufacture the products and ships the finished goods to the regional Scubapro warehouses, which are located in the USA, Europe, Oceania, and Asia. These locations will organize the final shipping to Scubapro authorized dealers, where divers can buy our products.